As of June 8th of 2025, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes can be found within Central America, where it contains one of the planet's most acidic volcanic crater lakes. There, at Costa Rica's Poas volcano, is a crater lake which has a pH of -0.87. This lake has largely vanished since this March due to an unusually high rate of both phreatic and phreatomagmatic eruptions from the same vent. As we can see from these photos taken on June 1st, these volcanic eruptions are still ongoing. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Italy, a portion of Mount Etna's southeast crater collapsed, generating a several-kilometer-long pyroclastic throat from the volcano, which sent hundreds of tourists fleeing away from it. Thankfully, no one was harmed. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the Raung volcano produced a new explosive eruption and is currently generating a sustained, albeit low-level, ash plume. And in what is this week's top story, a major paroxysm occurred at Guatemala's Fuego volcano, generating long-reaching pyroclastic flows and causing the evacuation of several hundred residents. After nearly 3 months of weaker eruptive activity consisting of both Strombolian and Vulcanian explosions every 5 to 20 minutes, activity suddenly escalated during the afternoon hours of June 4th, marking the onset of a new paroxysm. Initially, weak Strombolian activity became stronger and more frequent, feeding a growing sustained lava flow which descended 1,300 meters into the volcano's ceniza drainage. As the eruption transitioned into a continuous one, just after midnight local time, a 150-meter-high lava fountain was generated, occurring alongside Strombolian explosions which caused large flames of lava to tumble down Fuego's various slopes, creating a spectacular sight easily visible from afar. Around 5 a.m., eruptive activity switched from Strombolian to Vulcanian, now generating sustained ash emissions which rose up to an altitude of 21,000 feet or 6,401 meters. Following this, a series of pyroclastic flows were generated, which only ended up traveling down all of the volcano's drainages, the furthest ones kept traveling increasing distances within the Santa Teresa drainage. As a result, nearly 750 people were evacuated from three local villages. While this was occurring, the longest pyroclastic flow of the day struck, traveling a full 7.7 kilometers or 4.8 miles down the Santa Teresa drainage, getting a bit too close for comfort but not touching the closest structures. Thankfully, explosive activity would slowly decrease, and by the following day, the paroxysm was declared as over, although Fuego is still erupting. The evacuations were then rescinded. What had just occurred was Fuego's first paroxysm in 87 days, which, while not always true, often the longer amount of time between two paroxysms, the larger the resulting paroxysm ends up being. The Fuego volcano in the long term has produced paroxysms as frequently as 10 days apart or as long as 10 years apart. Meanwhile, in Italy, there thankfully were no injuries or worse of any kind when Mount Etna's southeast crater experienced a partial collapse on June 2nd. This collapse occurred at 11:23 a.m. local time when a volcanic explosion caused around 1 million cubic meters of the volcanic cone to collapse to the northeast, rapidly carving away a series of three deep scarps in the ground. Due to the removal of this material, a large pyroclastic flow was generated which moved at a speed downslope of 87.2 miles per hour or 140.4 kilometers per hour. During its travel up to 3.26 kilometers or 2.03 miles away, numerous people fled and filmed the eruption, but thankfully no one was ever seemingly within less than a half mile of the pyroclastic flow. In only 84 seconds time, an area of 2.75 square kilometers or 1.06 square miles was scorched. While what had just occurred was Etna's longest traveling pyroclastic flow in at least the last three decades, similar volume collapses had occurred from the same southeast crater on February 11, 2014 and February 10, 2022. Meanwhile, on the eastern end of the island of Java, the towering Raung volcano, which translates to Roaring Mountain, erupted anew, sending a plume of ash several hundred meters above its summit on June 5th. This phreatic eruption intensified the following day and ever since has been producing a low-level continuous ash plume visible from satellite. It may now only be a matter of time until a true magmatic, in this case, Strombolian eruption begins from Raung's summit. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on June 7th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Mary Jones, for supporting my work.